I'm meeting Laker Joe over here in East Oceanside. A relatively modest part of town. He had a listing really catch fire this weekend, so we're going to discuss it and make note of current market conditions in a regular track neighborhood where comp should be obvious and Zestimates and Redfin guesses be pretty close, because for at least 2 mile radius from here is all track houses. So it really shouldn't be that hard. There it is right there. All right, here's what we got. Just 1271 square feet. Nothing too big and fancy. Built in 88, standard track house. Been improved nicely though. Wow, what happened there? This is what happened. That is being overwhelmed by realtors and showings. Joe, being a good realtor, great realtor, did open house. The open house extravaganza last weekend. How many people came?
Over the 2 days, 500 people.
500? To see a 1,200 square foot house. It's nice. Let's take a little look around. Got a kitchen, but well, wait, this is the entire living area dominated by this built-in TV cabinet, we'll call it. So you gotta be able to live right here. That's it. How many offers have you gotten?
25 offers.
25 offers? So you must have raised the price.
We sure did. Went from 800,000 to 900,000.
All right, here's what everybody wants to know. When you priced it at 800,000, did you and the sellers get together and say, hey, we want to list it at an artificially low price to get a real frenzy going? Or did you say, according to the comps, this would be a smart price to put on it and we should get some good action?
That what we did was we put it, I looked at the comps supported that price, and it was twofold. We also wanted to get multiple offers in on the property. I did not expect this kind of, as you put it, frenzy, and it was. So
we'll call it an attractive price.
It was an attractive price. It was part of my marketing strategy, as was the staging, as was to get everything ready to make this home looking good for the market. We did some homework on this one, Jim.
Is that your staging?
Well,
kind of looks like the extent of it. Oh, we got some.
Well, what we did was we cleared it out. We have such a small living space.
Yeah. Just leave it.
We cleared it out. These two, I love this. We had to put some, so we have these two chairs which opened it up.
At least to give them something to work with visually.
Exactly.
It could have been the laundry. This is a heck of a laundry room. Yeah. People dig that. And in fact, when you're talking about what to do to your house to sell it for top dollar, this shower in the primary bathroom is fantastic. Because if you got a one-story house, you're already attracting the senior crowd. And when they see a shower like this, it's not like it's super duper fancy, but it's clean, tidy, and they can walk right in and take a shower today. That helped propel this sale, I'm sure of it. 25 offers. And people are probably just going crazy. If you're raising the price to 900, you're at least that. How many are over 900,000?
Six.
Six offers over 900 on an 800,000 list price, really. Smart move to raise the price, start sending the message to anybody else that's in play. Hey, it's a new game, new day.
Exactly.
That's awesome.
Yep. And I was taught by Jim, the realtor, how to do an open house many moons ago. And I've learned a couple things over the years, too. So what we do is we, good colleagues like this, we talk and we help each other out in this world. So.
Yeah, that's awesome.
And it matters who you hire. It really does. When Jim has one of his buyers come into my listings, it helps to know you're going to be with a pro on the other end.
Yeah, that's awesome. Thanks for that. Here's a question that realtors don't like to answer. What do you think this all means for the future? Can you make any predictions on the future?
I think
when you see something like this happen?
I think some of our chickens are coming home to roost from not building enough around here. There's just not enough inventory. There just isn't. So, and it's going to cause more people to leave the area because people just want a home.
Yeah.
They just want a home to raise their kids.
And so, I think we can admit that this house isn't some swanky custom estate. This is a pretty basic track house.
Exactly.
And it's nicely improved. The backyard is fantastic. Backyard probably drove it.
They did a great job.
Let's take a little look at that just so we get the full picture. But just being clean, tidy, having a new kitchen, new primary shower.
No HOA was attractive.
Oh, no HOA is awesome. And a very well improved backyard.
They built up to a 1,200 square foot ADU here as well. There are a few folks interested in that.
But everyone's going to come out here and say, this is ready to go. I don't have to do a thing. Quiet here. Even got the owl box. Is that what that is? Got solar going. That's leased or owned? The solar.
Owned solar.
Oh, that's going to clinch it right there. All right. We will check back with Joe to get a final report when it's all done. Thanks, Laker Joe.
You got it.